Hello, welcome back to the reading of article published on yours.org by Bitcoin Optimist. Problem and verdict. We've touched on Bitcoin's goal, the necessities to achieve it, and the roadblocks surrounding it. As we've alluded to, the most important roadblock Bitcoin must avoid is the roadblock of high fees and slow transaction times. Bitcoin will not be able to disrupt the traditional financial system or outcompete alternative cryptocurrencies if it loses these primary advantages. This is why, essentially, Bitcoin needs to be like Amazon.com. Amazon have thrived by combining the fastest delivery with the lowest prices possible. Amazon has scaled exceptionally well by adopting this strategy, and the reputation it gained from it causes people to start with them when shopping online. Now, imagine if Amazon switched gears and began significantly marking up their products or stopped caring about how fast customers got their shipments. If they went this route, they would fall out of favor and competitors like Walmart would pick up the slack. Customers would likely convert for the simple reason that they have economic incentive to do so. After all, they are not going to pay higher fees or wait longer for delivery when they don't have to. In that same sense, Bitcoin cannot lose its most important advantages either. Otherwise, the competition will take its customers away from it, just as Walmart has hypothetically done to Amazon in this example. Bitcoin cryptocurrency market share prior to the bottleneck was more than 80%. Bitcoin cryptocurrency market share after the bottleneck is less than 50%. Understanding the importance of retaining superiorities and fostering conditions needed to accelerate adoption growth, we can now determine how the two scaling options stack up in relation to the problem and goal. Block size increase, Bitcoin Cash. Increasing the block size is a very simple method of scaling. It allows for far greater number of transactions proceed within each block and ensures transaction will not be backlogged. This method of scaling keeps Bitcoin's basic transaction structure intact and puts it on a path where scaling and high fees will not be an issue for the foreseeable future. This has been the scaling method used in the past, and this is the path that Bitcoin Cash chooses. In brackets, don't fix what aren't broke. SegWit plus Lightning Network. SegWit decreases the amount of data used in a transaction, which effectively doubles the block size in its own right. However, this is a short-term scaling solution as the capacity increase alone will not scale Bitcoin to worldwide levels. As growth increases, the extra capacity that SegWit provides would fill up, and the cap would inevitably be reached again. Knowing this, the development team behind SegWit formulated a plan to scale Bitcoin using a sidechain called the Lightning Network. They are of the opinion that Bitcoin itself cannot scale to worldwide levels, but believe this network will give it the ability. This sounds great if a working implementation existed, but currently it only exists in theory. Without getting too technical, and to better understand why this is an inferior method of scaling, we will analyze how the Lightning Network works into the three need improvement aspects necessary for accomplishing Bitcoin's goal. first, a basic overview of how the Lightning networks operates. Lightning network equals conduct an on-the-blockchain transaction to get onto the Lightning network. Open up payment channels with others. Send money to others within the network. Close channel and leave network with an on-the-blockchain transaction. Ease of use. To open up a channel using the Lightning network, a user is required to move their Bitcoin onto the network with an on-chain transaction. Then, the user needs to operate within the channel. Once they're finished and wish to close the channel, they will need to conduct an on-chain transaction that records the net effect of their Lightning network transactions. This adds additional steps, layers of complexity, and it still requires users to conduct on-chain transactions. For the highly technical, this might seem really cool. For the normal person, it sounds overwhelming. As a result, this added layer of complexity is unlikely to increase adoption of the everyday person. Merchants' adoption. When a person buys a product or service, they simultaneously pay and receive the product or service. They do not typically form an ongoing financial relationship with a merchant or business. As the Lightning network requires parties to open up a payment channel with one another, and because it requires an on-chain and off-chain transactions anyway, why would anybody open up a payment channel to conduct a one-time transaction? Quite simply, they wouldn't. Because of this, the Lightning network's use case for merchants is limited. If the Lightning network was the main method for scaling, it would not assist in growth of merchant adoption. Additional use cases. The Lightning network does have theoretical use cases itself, but because one has to enter and exit the network through the Bitcoin blockchain, additional use cases can only come from within. However, theoretically, it does have multiple use cases itself, such as forming payment channels between parties where many small microtransactions will be made, or between parties making money, recurring payments with one another. Using the Lightning network to avoid mining fees under these circumstances could certainly be useful. Therefore, it does have use case itself, but only from within its own network. SegWit Lightning Network conclusion in the next video. Thank you.